YouTube, and welcome to this week's New Who review. I am Davros and I am Whovian, and today we are reviewing Doctor Who Arachnids in the UK. So, basically, the Doctor has managed to get Graham, Ryan and Yaz home in one piece in Sheffield. So we're back here. Yes, and along the way they find that there's something very wrong with the spiders in Sheffield. And I have to admit, I have seen a lot of giant spiders in a lot of the Halloween stores. Anyway, before we carry on any further in this review, I should warn you now, there will be spoilers, so as usual, if you've not seen the episode, go watch it, then you can come back and watch this review. Okay, so, basically, yeah, like I've just said, I'm giving you a brief thing of the plot there. So let's get on with the likes and dislikes. So first of all, my likes. As always, I liked Jodie Whittaker's performance in this as the Doctor. To be fair, I really have warmed up to her. And yeah, I'm impressed by her. She has proven that a woman can do a man's job, even though that shouldn't really matter these days because, you know, yeah, she's a good Doctor and I enjoy her. She has that Matt Smith feel to her, that, like, David Tennant sympathy of her. That odd dress sense of Colin Baker and some of her own material too, and I don't think I've said enough of that about her as the Doctor, but yes, I enjoyed her performance in this, along with Bradley Walsh as Graham. You know, I mean, although we're like four episodes in now, he's still grieving, and like you said, grief takes time. It really does. Also, Yaz and Ryan, you know, Tosin and Mandip Gill, they were both great in this too. And yeah, I just love the gang already. You know, they're the perfect TARDIS. Well, yeah, they're good. I enjoy them and that. And yeah, I really, you know, I'm loving this series so far. Okay, so the spiders. Well, basically, what it was this business guy. He was a bit of a dick, and he didn't care about health and safety on this hotel he'd constructed, and there were lots of toxic waste chemicals in the underground, in the mining of the hotel, and then there were spider carcasses which this research facility dumped down into the sewers or what have you, and from that the spiders and the toxic waste grew them big. And as the Doctor said, spiders grow bigger, they're always growing. So yeah, the spiders. This was a huge tribute to the 1974 John Pertwee serial, Planet of the Spiders. Because I don't think we've seen proper giant spiders in this since 1974, since John Pertwee's run. And when they were asking the question, what is it that's making the spiders big? I was like, metabilis crystals? But it wasn't metabilis crystals, I've just told you that. Also, the spiders were just big. You know, they grew from different sizes and that. But then there was, like, in Planet of the Spiders, that queen spider, the mother spider. And, yeah. There was that. These spiders didn't talk telepathically, though, like in Planet of the Spiders. Or control people. You know, but yeah, that's all I kept thinking about for watching this episode was Planet of the Spiders. And you know, I'm sure you all agree with me on that, you know, if you know that story, if you've seen that serial. If not, I highly recommend it to you. I also loved that these monsters weren't a huge threat. They had no intention of threatening Oro. They were just spiders that had their environment messed up, and they were growing big, and they just, you know, they were more afraid of us than we are of them. And of course, if you're an arachnophobe, I imagine you would have watched this behind your sofa. I've got a cousin who's absolutely terrified of spiders, can't even look at them, and I imagine he'd have been watching it behind the couch. Those are it. Another thing I liked is that we were back home in Sheffield, and when I was watching it, they were at Park Hill Flats in Sheffield, and we had some trams go past, like a Mailing Bridge tram, made of wall tram. But when I looked at Park Hill Flats, I thought, oh my god, I was there! I was there that very day, because I was. I really was there that very day they were filming at Park Hill Flats. But the security team told us to leave the premises and put our phones away, which was unfortunate. But still, just knowing that I was there that very day they were filming just excited me, you know. And, you know, I've never been so thrilled and happy to live where I am. I know I'm banging on about it now, and I'm probably starting to annoy everyone with that. But, you know, it's just Doctor Who in Sheffield, you know. I mean, it's like, I think this is what people get like in Cardiff when, you know, it's there. But yes, I just absolutely loved this episode with the spiders. My dislikes, I guess I didn't like the business guy. I can't remember his name now, but I didn't like him. But again, I don't think you're meant to like him, because he was meant to be an unlikable character, because he was a business guy that only had dollar signs in his eyes. This was a great episode, and this series has been great so far, and I honestly enjoy the hell out of it. So yeah, my final thoughts and ratings. I thought this was a great story. You know, it kept me entertained throughout. You know, so with all that being said, I'm going to give Arachnids in the UK. I think I'll give this. Yeah, I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5. 4 out of 5 for Arachnids in the UK. So that has been my Who review on Arachnids in the UK. Have you seen the episode yet? Let me know down in the comments below, because you probably have, because I warned you about the spoilers. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. All my social media links are linked down below in the description. So, I've been Davros the Whovian, so until next time, run for your life.